We're talking about chords on the top three strings today. Why? Because they're fun, and it's kind of easy to do, and it kind of instills this cool guitar concept that I really like. Let me introduce you to the shapes. Our first shape is a D shape. It's also just called a D chord. In this case, we're just playing the top three strings. G, B, and E string. The next shape I want to show you is the A shape. We're just going to talk about the top three strings. So in open position, you only need two fingers to play this. But if you move this shape up, you've got to bring this note with you. Instead of using my second and third finger to play this, I'm going to use my third and fourth finger to play this. And then that gives me a chance to grab this note here when I scoot the shape up. So if I scoot it up one fret, now my first finger has come with, and I can move this shape around. The final shape I want to talk about is the E shape, which in this position, it's hard to tell that it's an E shape, but if I scoot it back, you can see, oh, here's an E chord. I'm taking just the top three strings, and then these ones have to come with when I move up, so I'm gonna end up going like this. That kind of thing. What I like about these chords is they are just the bare essentials. You've got a root, a third, and a fifth. If you don't know what that means right now, that's just fine. Maybe in a later video I'll talk about what root, third, and fifth means. But for now, we're just going to talk about roots and thirds. First, let's talk about the root notes of the chords. The root note is the part of the chord that gives the chord its name. So this is a D major chord. And this is the root note. So wherever I put a root note on the B string, I can surround that root note with the D shape, and that makes it, whatever note this is, it makes it that chord. So this is a G, and this is a G chord, a G major chord. If I move this finger up to, here's a B, and surround it with the D shape, I now have a B chord, a B major chord. Here's a D, if I can move up to E, F, and then I make the same shape, I know that's now an F chord. An F major chord. For the A shape, the root note is on the G string. Here's a G, G sharp, A. So I know if I make this A shape around this A chord, that it's an A major chord. If I scoot my A up to C, A, B, C, and then I surround it with the A shape, that's a C chord. So if I move this shape up to G, surround it with the A shape, that's a G major chord. With the E shape, the E string is the root note. So if I move that root note, E, F, F sharp, G, if I attach the E shape to this note, it becomes a G major chord. So what's cool about this is I can say, okay, here's an open A chord, and now where's my nearest A, here's my root note right here, but I need to find another root note. I can go E, F, G, A. Now I can play an A chord with an E shape. And then my nearest A from here is E, F, G, A. I can surround that with the D shape because it's on the B string. B string, D shape. E string, E shape. And G string, A shape. So if I do this with a D chord, I can go, okay, here's my D chord. This note is D. So my nearest D from here is, here's A, B, C, D. So that's on the G string. If I attach the A shape to that D note on the G string, it becomes a D chord. Now my next D is A, B, C, D. I know that this D is on the E string. So if I attach an E shape to it like this, I know it's a D chord. Pretty cool, right? So now that we've talked about how to move these shapes around, we've got to talk about how to make them minor. Thirds are responsible for making a chord major or minor. So let's start with the D shape. Here, we've got D, just on the top three strings, and we know that the root note is always on the B string, and the third is always right here. Why is that important? Well, because if we know this is the third, and we know this is a major chord, we can take the third and we can flat it. we got to flat it by moving it back one fret, and then we got to incorporate that note into the chord. And now this is a D minor chord. D major, flat the third, D minor. What's cool about this is it's still the same movable shape. If you know that the root note is on the B string, you can go, okay, here's an F, here is an F minor, here's an F major. If I go up to A, F, G, A, and then I make this D minor shape, now it's an A minor chord. A major, flat the third, A minor. With the A shape, this one goes in order. This one goes root, third, fifth. So I know my root is on the G string. The third is right below it. So if I flat that note, back half a step that way, major, flat the third, minor. The root note still stays in the same place, so my root note is here. If I go up to G, C, D, E, F, G, I'm gonna make G major, G minor. Pretty cool, huh? With the E shape, which I'll play on G here, so this is a G chord in the E shape, the third is actually on the G string here. So I've got my root down here, and I got my third down here. So if I flat the third, you can just bar straight across. You can also play it sort of like an A chord, but I prefer to bar it. So now we have a G minor chord. And if I go G, A, B, here is a B minor chord. Here's a B major chord. If your friend wants to jam, say she's playing a C, A minor, and an F. So, let me break down what I just did. I started with an E-shaped C chord on the 8th fret. Here's C, E, F, G, A, B, C. And because this C is on the E string, I can play an E shape. And because I need a C major chord, I've got to make the major shape, not the minor shape. So here's a C. Now if I back down C, B, A to this A, still on the E string, but this time it's a minor chord, so I gotta make the E minor shape. And then the next chord was, I found an F right here on the B string. And because that F is on the B string, I can play a D shape. So here I have a C chord. Here I have an A minor chord. And here I have an F chord. And then what I did the second time around is I went, well, I know there's a C right here. It's actually part of the F chord. So if I just convert this to an A shape, now it's a C chord. And then I went back to this E minor shaped A minor chord. And then I went up to, I know there's an F right here on the G string. I went C, D, E, F. And now I can make an A shape there. So I went. So let's talk about some ways to practice this. I have a jam track that is just A major and B minor. So what we can do here before we get started is we can map out all the A majors and B minors up the neck. Part of the reason I'm starting with this one is if you find an A, you know there's always a B a whole step away. So for example, down here on this open A chord, I know this is A, so I know there's a B right here. So I have an A-shaped A chord, that's easy. And then I have B right here, so that has to be B minor, so here's an A minor shaped B minor. Remember, this is what it would be if it was major, but gotta make it minor. So then here is my next A, E, F, G, A. So now we've got, that's on the E string, so I gotta play an E shape. And then I know, since this is A, B is a whole step in front. Now I gotta play the E minor shape, and that makes it a B minor chord. Now my next A is right here. You got F sharp, G, A right here. So that's on the B string, so it's got to be a D shape. And now we've got a whole step in front of this is B. And now since it's a B minor chord, we've got to make this shape into a minor shape. And you see, they all contain the same notes. This is A, C, E, B, D, F sharp, and then this is A, C, E, B, D, F sharp, and then this is A, C, E, B, D, F sharp. That's how guitar works. It's so cool, right? I love this stuff. I'm gonna pull up this jam track. Give me a second here. So if we go to my website here, and then pull up a jam track in A major, here it is. So it's gonna start with A. So I'm just gonna lay out these shapes here. We got A, A, A. Then we got B minor, B minor, B minor. But we could go. Anyways, pretty cool, right?